Taiwanese Foreign Minister Joseph Wu criticized the Chinese government for pushing its political agenda amid the ongoing crisis, and warned that China will likely push Taiwan after it takes away Hong Kong's autonomy. Taiwan has been ruled separately from China since the end of a civil war in 1949, but China considers it a part of its territory and has threatened to bring it into its fold, even if that needs military intervention. In 1979, the United States normalized diplomatic relations with the Beijing government under the Communist Party of China. Since then, the relation between Taiwan and the United States became unofficial and informal and is governed by the Taiwan Relations Act. The Taiwan Relations Act is designed to maintain ambiguity and does not state if the USA will or will not intervene militarily if the PRC attacks or invades Taiwan. Under the Act, the U.S. is obligated to sell arms of a defensive character to Taiwan. Beijing has stepped up diplomatic and military pressure on Taipei since the election in 2016. In the election, Tsai Ing-wen became president, whose Democratic Progressive Party refuses to acknowledge that Taiwan is part of One China. Taiwan's economy and the defense budget is a fraction of China's. In purely military terms, it's hugely outnumbered in both men and material. But Taiwan has weapons and is also acquiring new ones that can hold off China for a considerable duration and allow time for international diplomatic pressure to mount, as well as provide scope for U.S. military intervention. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why China will not have a swift victory over Taiwan. Let's get into details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. FIM-92 Stinger is a man-portable air defense system, man pads, that operates as an infrared homing surface-to-air missile, SAM. Stinger entered service in 1981 and is manufactured by Raytheon Missile Systems. FIM-92 Stinger is a passive surface-to-air missile system consisting of a launcher and missiles. Stinger is light to carry and easy to operate. It can be used by a single person or a two-member team consisting of a team chief and gunner. The Stinger is launched by a small ejection motor that pushes it a safe distance from the operator. Then the main two-stage solid fuel sustainer propels it forward and accelerates it to a speed of Mach 2.54. It has a maximum range of 8 kilometers or 5 miles. The missile has infrared homing and UV detector for guidance, and 3 kilogram or 6.6 pound high explosive annular blast fragmentation warhead. Taiwan is getting 250 Stingers from the US and will fit nicely into the Taiwan strategy of asymmetric warfare. These could be used to target Chinese air assets. Abrams was first introduced in 1980 to replace the M60 main battle tank, which was introduced in 1960. It was significantly more potent than the M60 and featured many top-of-the-line components, like a fire control system that allowed up to 90% accuracy at ranges of 2,000 meters. The tank was technologically well ahead of most other tanks of its era. U.S. military has kept on upgrading the tank to maintain its edge. Taiwan will receive M1A2T, which is a special configuration of the M1A2C. M1A2C is the latest variant of Abrams and contains many improvements over its predecessor and is better equipped for current battlefield scenarios. This includes an ammunition data link for improved targeting, the addition of enhanced infrared sights, and auxiliary power unit APU. M1A2C will see better protection as it will add passive armor, as well as a new explosive reactive armor ERA package, known as the Abrams Reactive Armor Tile, ARIT. Another important upgrade is the addition of the Trophy Active Protection System, APS, that can neutralize incoming projectiles. A better gun will also be present. The main difference between the M1A2T and M1A2C is that it will have tungsten carbide armor instead of depleted uranium armor. The M1A2s will likely be added to two armored battalions in northern Taiwan and is expected to replace some of the aging M60A3 Patton and CM11 Brave Tiger tanks currently in service. These are expected to be deployed by 2022. These will go a long way when it comes to the ability of Taiwan to counter a Chinese thrust in the event of an invasion. The Hsiung-Feng 3 is a supersonic anti-ship cruise missile. It's Taiwan's first supersonic missile and has an operational range of 150 kilometers or about 90 miles. It's the third and latest variant developed within Taiwan's Hsiung-Feng cruise missile family, following the Hsiung-Feng 2. The missile is propelled by a solid-fueled booster and liquid-fueled ramjet engine. Taiwan began the Hsiung-Feng 3 program in 1994 to counter the growing number of China's surface vessels and its advancing fleet defense systems. It was developed by the National Chung Cheng Institute of Science and Technology, NCSIST. More than 250 of these are reportedly built. Several reports in 2017 have signaled the development of an ER or extended range Hsiung-Feng 3, which has a range of 400 kilometers or about 250 miles. It's believed that Taiwan already has built 60 of these. Taiwanese media in August last year reported that the country's National Chung Shan Institute of Science and Technology had cleared the Yunfeng cruise missile for mass production. The supersonic land attack missile has been under development since the 1990s. It can fly as far as 1,200 miles, or about 1,930 kilometers, according to the Center for Strategic and International Studies in Washington, D.C. The range will allow Taiwan to threaten many important infrastructures like air bases and ports, from which China could initiate an offensive to invade Taiwan. Taipei reportedly is building an initial 20 Yunfeng missiles as well as 10 truck-based launchers. The F-16 is a single-engine, supersonic, multi-role fighter aircraft originally developed by General Dynamics, which is now Lockheed Martin, for the United States Air Force. It was primarily designed to be an air superiority day fighter, but has evolved into a successful all-weather multi-role aircraft. Over 4,500 aircraft have been built since production started in 1976. U.S. Air Force no longer buys it, but is still being built for exporting, and there's still a good demand for the fighter. It has a maximum speed of Mach 2 and a combat radius of 340 miles or 550 kilometers. The fighter can be armed with a wide range of air-to-air, air-to-ground, and anti-ship weapons. For air-to-air combat, it can carry AIM-7 Sparrow, AIM-9 Sidewinder, AIM-120 AMRAAM, Iris-T, Python-4, and Python-5. For air-to-ground attack, it can deploy several types of smart bombs and missiles like the AGM-65 Maverick, AGM-88 HARM, and AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile, JASSM. For anti-ship role, it can be equipped with AGM-84 Harpoon and AGM-119 Penguin. The F-16 has seen many upgrades over the years. The V, or Viper, variant has the Northrop Grumman AN-APG 83 Scalable Agile Beam Radar, SABR, which is much more capable. Another aspect is that the variant has Center Pedestal Display, CPD, which will enhance situational awareness to a considerable extent. Taiwan will receive 66 F-16V by 2026. Importantly, its existing fleet of 142 F-16A and F-16B fighter jets will also be upgraded to V variant. So the island expects to have a total of 208 F-16Vs by 2026.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.